For anyone still waiting, all the invitations for Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's wedding have now been sent out, we're afraid to say. Kensington Palace announced that 600 people have been invited to the service at St. George's Chapel in Windsor Castle and then to a lunchtime reception at St. George's Hall, which is being given by the Queen. Advertisement, continue reading below. The wedding party then shrinks by a third as just 200 evening guests have been invited to a private reception at Frogmore House, which will be held by Harry's father Prince Charles. Getty Images. So, where is this venue exactly and why has it been chosen as the epicenter of a very momentous royal occasion? Location: Frogmore House is found just half a mile south of Windsor Castle in Windsor Home Park, Berkshire. Historical background: the house was first built in 1680 by Charles II's architect Hugh May for his nephew. Its peculiar name was given because of the frogs, which have always lived in the marshy area, according to the royal family's website. From the early 1700s, the house was leased to the Duke and Duchess of Northumberland, an Puritan landowner, until Queen Charlotte, the wife of King George III, needed a country home for herself and bought the lease in 1792, officially bringing it into the royal family. It's actually where Prince Albert Victor, the son of King Edward VIII, was born. Queen Victoria's mother, the Duchess of Kent, lived there too for about 20 years. Advertisement, continue reading below. In 1923, the Queen's mother and father, King George V and the Queen Mother, spent part of their honeymoon there when they were Duke and Duchess of York. The interiors of many parts of the house are influenced by members of the family, who resided and visited there at various times. Gardens. Originally, the impressive gardens were flat, but in the 1790s, Queen Charlotte's staff created lakes, mounds, glades, walks and bridges which contributed to the picturesque landscape of the grounds today. Queen Charlotte had a passion for botanics and gardening and introduced more than 4,000 trees and shrubs to the grounds, according to the Royal Collection Trust. Within the grounds there is also the mausoleum, where both Queen Victoria and Prince Albert are buried. The royal burial ground is also found at Frogmore, where the Duke of Windsor and Wallace Simpson are buried. Its meaning to the Queen. Over the years, the Queen, Duke of Edinburgh and their family have been photographed and filmed enjoying some time out at Frogmore House. In 1965, on the Queen's 39th birthday, the family, including a baby Prince Edward in a pushchair, were seen strolling around the gardens. Getty Images. Advertisement, continue reading below. Advertisement, continue reading below. A few years later, in 1968, they returned. Getty Images. In 1974, the family, minus Prince Charles, were seen again walking around the grounds with corgis in tow, admiring the lakes and greenery. Advertisement, continue reading below. Last year, the Queen said Frogmore House holds a special place in my family's affection, and that the area remains a wonderfully relaxing environment for her and her family. Relevance to Harry and Meghan. Own time we know of for definite, when Harry and Meghan visited, was when their official engagement photos were taken. The couple released their photos just before Christmas last year, and revealed they had been taken by photographer Alexei Lubomirsky at Frogmore House that week. In the beautiful portraits, the couple shunned the cold December weather to sit on the steps of the house, all while Meghan wore a stunning Ralph. Yes, but only on limited days. Frogmore House and Gardens are only open to the public for 3 days in spring and a select more in August.